As my girlfriend's birthday was coming up and she had just a basic bulb as ceiling light in her room, I thought of making one for her. She always wanted to have a chandelier, but we never found one which fits the style of her room. So I had a look in the internet to get some inspiration. When I had an idea of what the chandelier should look like, I started to sketch Infusion. I wanted to make the chandelier just out of three different parts. These parts should repeat over and over to make the whole chandelier. So I sketched these three parts first. Two of them should be the two different types of arms of the chandelier, and the third one is to connect these arms. Then it was just a matter of assembling all the parts in the right orientation. So there are two things about this step. The first thing I like, the second I don't. The first thing is that you can already see if all parts fit together. And you also see if your design idea works. So you see the end result, but you're still able to change things. What I don't like about it is that you already see how it will look like in the end, so it's less exciting to build it. But in this case, I didn't model the bulbs, so there's still a little bit of surprise how it will look like in the end with the bulbs. The last step at the computer is to lay out the parts on the sheet size and to set the machine path. I used 18mm beech plywood for this project because plywood is a good material for these kind of parts, and I had enough of it for this project in my shop. Now that the computer work was done, I had to cut the plywood sheet to fit onto my CNC machine. I used an 8mm spiral upcutting router bit. With this, the CNC machine had to do 4 passes for each part. From this point it's pretty easy, you just have to wait until the CNC is ready and watch its satisfying action. But just until that happened. This was probably my fault and not a defect of the CNC machine, but more about that maybe in a future video. As my CNC machine was broken and I really didn't have enough time to fix it, I had to think of another way to finish the project by the birthday of my girlfriend. Luckily, there was at least one of each three different parts ready before the CNC broke. So I could use these as templates to make the other ones. At first, I copied the outlines of the parts onto the sheet of plywood. Then I quickly cut it out with a jigsaw slightly bigger. Okay, unfortunately it's not quickly, so let's skip this. After cutting them roughly to size, I had to trim them to be an exact copy of the ones made by the CNC. So I took the strongest double-sided tape I found to stick the roughly sized part to the one that's already finished. With this setup, I had a perfect guidance for the bearing of the flush trim router bit to run along. I was a little bit afraid of splintering by tearing the two pieces apart again, but that turned out to be no problem. Now I had to change the router bit to a disc cutter to cut the slots for the wires. As the disc cutter is thinner than the wire, I offset it a little bit from the middle and run along with the piece from both sides, so the slot is exactly in the middle and wide enough for the wire. And there was to cut another groove to get to the underside of the bulb with the wire. These two grooves will later be connected with a hole. Now it was a matter of drilling lots of holes. There's one to mount the sockets of the bulbs. And another one to feed the wire under the socket through the arm. Well, actually it's one hole but with two sizes, so you have to drill two times there. You know what I mean. And the third one is the hole to connect the two grooves under the arm that I already mentioned. As you can see, it's already time for sanding all the parts. At first I thought of sanding all the parts by hand because they are pretty small and curved, but after the second part I changed my mind and used my small eccentric sander. I've just put on the soft sanding pad, with that it worked out as well. With all the wooden parts are oiled, everything is ready to be assembled. The assembling for me is the most exciting step in the whole process. But as I know, it's not that exciting to watch in a video, so I'll keep that short. All the 12 arms of the chandelier are connected with the part at the top and the part at the bottom that I mentioned in the beginning. At the bottom, it's just stuck together with doubles. At the top, I just used 12 tiny screws, one for each arm. You can see the 7 holes in the upper connection part. These are for the wires of the bulbs. 6 on the arms and a 7th in the middle of the chandelier. With the 6 bulb arms mounted, it was time for the sockets to get in place. These sockets are meant to be hanging on a wire from the ceiling, so they have a clamping mechanism to the wire. By unscrewing this, I had some free threads I could just turn into the wood. The next step is to wire the whole thing up before putting the other 6 arms in place. I stick the wire through the holes, connected it to the socket and pushed it into its groove. There it's held just by friction. The last wire was the one for the big bulb in the middle. This time I could use the socket as it's meant to be, as it's just hanging on the wire. To keep the wire from slipping through the hole, I used a wire clamping mechanism from one of the other sockets. When all the wires were connected to the sockets, I had to connect the wires among themselves. Now that the electrics were done, I finally could attach the other arms that don't carry a bulb. So, this is now the time to see if it actually works. So, I mounted a temporary plug to it and put the bulbs in. And this is what it looks like with all the bulbs in place. It was already my girlfriend's birthday, so we could directly mount it to her ceiling. And this is it. I'm pretty happy with how it turned out, and my girlfriend's probably too. If you have any questions about the build or anything else, feel free to ask in the comments. So it's nothing left to say, then thanks for watching.